In this packed children's ward in the main Abs hospital in the north of Yemen, anxious mothers vie for attention as Dr. Ali Al-Ashwal does his rounds. This little girl is named Hafsa. Her mother tells the doctor Hafsa has five brothers, all malnourished. But Hafsa is the only one they can afford the medicine for.
Assalamu alaikum.
This mother of an eight-month-old tells Dr. Al-Ashwal her little boy can no longer lift up his head. He's too weak. His little belly is painfully swollen, a telltale sign of acute malnutrition. Rows and rows of hungry children, their bodies so stripped of fat that every move is agony. Hard to believe, but these are the lucky ones. These are the children whose parents can afford the car journey to the hospital. Even for Yemen, this is not the norm. Every day brings dozens more patients. And more death. This patient died this week, a one-year-old called Fatma. It's very hard to keep track of exact figures for child deaths because so many of the children don't even make it to the hospital. All the doctor knows is that things are getting worse. Why is that? That lack of funding Dr. Al-Ashwal was talking about. 80% of the 30 million population in Yemen is reliant on aid, the majority of whom live in the Ansarullah Houthi-controlled north. The Houthis, seeking to control the flow of aid, placed restrictions on UN agencies in areas under their control. In March, the US suspended much of its aid to the north, citing concerns over Houthi misappropriation. Two other key donors, the United Arab Emirates and Saudi Arabia, have also drawn down. The US, UAE and Saudi Arabia have all slashed their Yemen aid spend. The US spend dropping from almost $1 billion to $411 million. Saudi from over $1 billion to half that, with only $22 million actually received. The UAE has given $0 to the UN's 2020 Yemen appeal. CNN was able to obtain access to a confidential internal UN briefing document. UN agencies have confirmed to us its contents. In the aftermath of the drop in foreign aid, the UN has shuttered almost 75% of its programs. In previous CNN investigations, we traced serial numbers on armaments in Yemen back to arms deals between Saudi Arabia, the UAE, and the US, proving that the US government has profited from the chaos of the war in Yemen. And aid agencies tell us the aid drawdown threatens to wreak even more havoc. Mushriya Farah pushes her disabled son in a wheelchair. Mushriya used to receive support through a UN-funded program. Now she can't even afford to get her son Asim to hospital. Malnutrition has left Asim mentally disabled, and she has to choose between feeding him or paying for treatment. She carries him through the little alley that leads to the half-finished building site where she and other displaced families have erected makeshift shelters. Up until a few months ago, she tells us Asim was like any little boy. But after the family were displaced from their home by fighting, now they live here. The aid suspension has driven the people of the Houthi-controlled north into deeper isolation. Yemen's north could already be in famine, and we might not even know it. Nima Elbagir, CNN, London.
CNN has received responses to our reporting from Saudi Arabia, the United States, and the United Arab Emirates. Now, the Saudi Foreign Ministry says it is providing nearly $77 million to Yemen this year and told CNN they intend to meet their full commitment. But the delay is in dispersing their pledged aid is, quote, based upon a request from the United Nations to have the announced pledge be paid in one upfront payment to each individual UN agency. The United States aid organization USAID points the finger of blame firmly at the Houthis for obstructing aid distribution in the north, but say they continue to support countrywide UN operations and some of our NGO partners' life-saving activities in the north. And they say they are by far the largest donor of humanitarian response to Yemen this year. And the United Arab Emirates told CNN it was the first country to respond to the coronavirus outbreak in Yemen and is one of the largest donors of humanitarian aid to Yemen, with more than $6 billion provided from 2015 until the end of August this year, 2020. All three reiterated their concerns over alleged Houthi misappropriation of aid.